Hello guys, welcome back to Ushi Gaming Channel. So in Higan Eruthyll, we just got a new update, which is a new banner. So another limited character, Antelo SSR and Tick Tock SR. She's a light elemental caster, a magic attacker basically. The passive skill, she's going to have a chance to do dual cast temporarily. 35% chance to trigger vitality. Decent enough, I think. 35% chance means in every 3 attacks, she will do dual cast, it seems. The basic attack, 200% AP, just like the other character. Now, the active skill. There are 2 kinds of active skills as usual. The first one is AoE, and it can remove 2 stacks of buff from the enemy. Okay, let it rain. The second one, Whirling Fungus. This one is single target with polymorphing the target for 5 seconds and inflicting 1 stack of muscarine, which is a DOT basically. Damage over time. Polymorph basically turn the unit into a harmless creature for a duration. It is just like polymorph on many other games. I think both of them are good, depend on what are you going to use her for. I mean, if the enemies are a lot and they are kinda close each other, then the first one could be better. AoE damage. If the enemy has like 1 or 2 enemies that are kind of very annoying, maybe you can try to use this. If you use this on PvP, the polymorph, basically, I think she's going to polymorph the enemy's tank. And I think that's going to be quite fun. And the ultimate, Full of Vigor. Chance of triggering vitality, the dual cast, increased by 15%. Chance of triggering vitality continuously increases by 10%. Skill damage increased by 50% and skill effect lasts for 12 seconds. So basically, depend on which active skill you are going to choose, the ultimate will going to buff that active skill. Looks like an interesting character. So I think I will try to get her with the limited amount of Dubrio style that I have, which is only 4k. Which means I think I can only do 20 pulls at most. Honestly, I'm kinda not sure if I'm able to get her in this video. But let's see. If somehow I able to get her, I think I will try to get the play as well. This one is quite interesting too. I think this is kinda specially designed for the new character. Energy recharge is increased by 25%. When casting a skill, it is magic damage critical rate increased by 5%, 20%, 35%, and 50% for the first 4 times. If the damage dealer is a Lumito character, besides the bonus critical rate, their skill rate critical damage increased by 10%, 20%, 30%, 40% for the first 4 times. So specially designed for the new character. The 4 stars increase AD by 10% upon casting a skill. Skill damage increased by 20% for 6 seconds. This effect can be triggered once every 20 seconds. I think you can use this for many AD DPS. So other than to use the new play for Antelo, I think you can also use that play for Media. This Media, she's also a light elemental caster. The free character that we all got and I didn't raise her because we have limited amount of resources to raise characters here, right? So I haven't raised my Media yet. So okay, I will try to get Antelo in this video. The new SR Tick Tock. This one is a water elemental hoplite. The normal attack is AoE with the clockwise clock. And iron skin mid, armor increased by 20%. So it seems like this character is the one that has more physical defense than magic defense. Basic attack, 180% AD, just like the other character. Now the active skill. This one can swap position with the target. Looks like a useful SR character. I think this could be useful for PvP. Swapping character. Tick Tock will swap position again 5 seconds later, during which the enemy's armor is reduced by 20%. Only 5 seconds. If Tick Tock recasts this skill during the period, she will swap position with the other selected target. Looks like a fun character to use. The other active skill. Tick Tock sweeps her weapon 3 times to deal physical damage equal to 3200 and 540% AD to enemies within an arc. Each time hitting an enemy, this skill has 65% chance to inflict 1 stack of encroaching cold. Doesn't seem to be that special, the second active skill. The first one looks interesting though. And the ultimate, petrify all enemies for 6 seconds and draws one self-skill card. Wow, this one looks really useful. Oh, okay. The ultimate makes her really good, I think. 6 seconds, guys. It's kinda weird that the SR character can petrify the enemy for 6 seconds. And it is AoE, guys. Meanwhile, the new SSR only polymorph one character. What the? It looks really weird though, because yeah, this polymorph is only for 5 seconds and it's only single target. For me, it seems that the SR character looks better than the SSR at the first glance. Okay, anyway, let's try to get her. Okay, the first ball. Hopefully I can get her with just one ball. Who knows? I know the rate is low, but who knows? I might going to get her. There's only one pull, please. Yellow. Oh. No. Okay, let's try it. The second and also the last pull that I can do for this banner. Well, who knows? Who knows? Okay, let's do this. The new character, please. Come on, yellow. Yeah, right. Okay, so other than the new limited character Antelo, we also got the rated up banner for Ciankom. I don't have her yet, and I think I might want to get her because yeah, I want to try to build an AP DPS team, because my only AP DPS at this moment is Clawar, which is starting from a quite low rarity. From 2 star if I'm not wrong, or 1 star, I forgot. So yeah, who knows, I can get this Ciankom from this banner. The other reason is because I have 112 star sigil, which is a summon ticket that I can only use on regular banner like this. Yeah, for the limited banner, I will use Duplio style for it, but for this kind of banner, I can use my tickets. So let's try Ciankom. Well, basically I can claim her for free from the PT, but who knows, I can get her directly. And who knows, I might going to get another SSR duplicate for my other characters. Okay, first pull, no yellow. Second pull, I will stop once I got a yellow, I think. Oh, I press skip immediately, okay. And no yellow. The third pull. It's kind of more fun if we watch the animation, because it's like yellow, yellow. Yeah, you know what I mean. Purple and yellow. Yellow. Nope. Okay, and getting the other character's duplicate is also good to awaken them. Come on. Something nice, please. SSR. Double yellow is possible. Yellow? Nope, not yet. Okay, I think the fifth pull already. Yeah, the fifth pull. Alright, yellow please. Purple, yellow? Not yet. The 6th, I think it's about the time. The PT is around 70 if I'm not wrong. 70 or 80, around there. Oh! I skipped it and I got a yellow and it is Fene again. Really? I haven't even raised her yet. So let's do it again. Why did I skip that one? It's kind of more fun to see that yellow. It's supposed to be. Come on, yellow. Again. Nope. Alright, a lot of purples. The 8th pool, I think. Come on, yellow. Yellow? Okay. 9. The 9th pool in this banner. In Ciankom's banner. It's already 11th pool in this video. Come on, yellow. Yellow. Alright. The 10th multiple. Let's go. Come on. Yellow. Oh yes. Finally I see a yellow here. Oh, nice one. I got Ciankom. All right, nice. I think this one is a good magical DPS because I fought this character quite a lot in arena and she was quite strong. Okay, nice. Wow, the PT, look at this. I can actually claim more of her, but no, I think. I can save this for future characters or maybe the characters that I need later in the future. Should I get this here? Maybe no, I'm just going to save the tickets for the playset that I really need later in the future. So yeah, I think that's all for now. Yeah. That's a new character. And I think we got new event here, Wonder Fantasy, again. So don't forget to do this daily, because the reward is really nice. Yeah, last time I got everything here. Ooh, okay. So thank you for watching, don't forget to leave a like, subscribe, and if you haven't, and see you again next time. Bye, Ushi Punch.